whatever's going to happen as we address the environmental issues and sustainability, we have to make sure we've got the brains to do that, the talent. So where do we find it? How do we identify it? And how do we retain that talent that has the creativity, the initiative to keep things moving forward? Well, who better to ask than the two guests that I have with me now? I have Dipak Mane, who's Chief Human Resources Officer at Bühler, and Irene Mark-Eisenring, Head of Personnel Development at Bühler. Welcome, both of you. Irene, the skills and education that people need today to look to the future, how do you identify? What do you look for?
So you mean in the labour market, when we look? I mean, first of all, it's all depending on the business strategy. And what we know now already, we know, for example, there are certain professions and skills we definitely need in the future. And these obviously will groom either through internal developing our people or through attraction from the market. So for example, we do know we need a pipeline of young leaders, the future leaders. So we have put programs together which are attractive, on the vocational side, on the graduate side, where we really attract them.
So as a company, Bühler has to be attractive, as Irene said, Dipak, but getting them in, getting the personnel in with the skills is one thing. Making sure they don't leave the week after is another. So how do you retain them?
So in a sense, the strategy of attraction actually kind of moves into the strategy for retention. So this whole concept of what you started to talk about, the purpose of sustainability of the two value chains, this is becoming an extremely good attractor of talent, because it's not just the young, but also the not so young are getting attracted, because these are serious problems in the world that we are addressing. So on the one side, it is an attractor. And once they come in, they actually see that this is a company that's actually walking the talk. So in that sense, that also then helps as a retainer for people. So they like to stay. That's one thing. The second thing is they see us as this completely landscape training and development company, right from the apprenticeship to having our own master of Bühler management. And then, you know, you can join our company when you're 15 and then go all the way to become a member of the executive board, for example. So they see the people out there, you know, been there with the company for 25 years, 30 years, 35 years. So all this combination also says that, no, that's a company on the one side is attractive. They walk the talk. On the second thing, and the third thing is, I can actually make a complete career, and I develop myself as a person. I can go out, I can see the world, I meet customers, people who are making the difference. I'm working with them every day, so that kind of is a pretty good combination, I think. So we got that act together somehow.
If you're looking, Irene, for say, anything from a data analyst to an engineer, I understand they have those skills. If those skills are good, you can take them on, but working and having a career and addressing the future is about more than that. There are soft skills like communication skills that need to be added. How do you polish those up, or how do you add those to somebody's skill set?
That's a very good question. We more and more look, even when we hire specialists, I mean, for some soft skills. This is changing and will even more change. So you can have both. You can be a specialist, but nevertheless already some feeling for soft skills. And we do really already look at more and more when we hire people. But obviously that will not be perfect, because they might be young, have not yet an education and that. And then we have specific programs where we do develop the soft skills. And we are convinced that they are getting more important. So we have for first line managers, we have leadership programs for the middle management. We have a very attractive program where during a year they spend time in different location and work on stuff. And also for the top management, we have programs. So we really have for each level of the organization leadership programs.
And as a woman, do you feel that you stand out in this company, or do you feel very much at home? There are more and more women joining Bühler.
Yes, this is a big focus of us. It's diversity. And it's not about just men, women. It's about different thinking, different approaches to problem. That is what is important. And we are really, really looking out for that. And obviously, if we can create this culture, if we do have leaders who are able to lead multicultural teams and so on, so create an inclusive atmosphere, we're also going to attract more women and retain more women. But diversity, and that's probably what you're alluding to, is a big topic of ours.
So we're talking about multinationalities as well.
As well, yeah.
Yes.
As well. So we talk about people from different nationalities, different religion, let's say different beliefs. So there what we are trying to do is especially our high potential people, we are also ensuring that they are given opportunities to actually move across continents. So there's a program in place that they actually get opportunities because you need to develop yourself, not just that you are different, but you need to also understand the other different people and learn to work with them, learn to be led by them, learn to lead them. And so all of this movement is also really helping us.
Well, here's a cheeky question. Mm-hmm. Either one of you can take this one, I don't mind. I come to you for a job and you give me the job. And I trust you to give me these skills. How do I know that you've got those skills to give me? How do I know that you keep your own skills up to date?
I think that's a cultural change we are in. I think, and I'll take the question, sorry,
yeah. You can.
It's the more we are looking for people who also have the ability to learn daily. I mean, that is important. And it's a two-way street. We need to have people who have this openness and not just coming, I'm a specialist, I stay like this for 20 years. The person has to have an openness, but we also need to foster this openness through role modeling, through leadership. So that will be important. It's a mutual trust level.
Mm, you agree, Dipak?
So that's the soft side of it, but there's also the hard side of skills, which also we take care. So there are a few things that we do. Number one, we are actually fostering a culture also of open innovation and open collaboration. So if you walk into the Cubic, you will not only see the Bühler people. So you have university graduates, you have startups. What happens is that then your skills are challenged. So we as an organization, our skills are challenged. People as people, their skills are challenged, and then they can come back to us. And then we are seeing this every day. So we keep changing these programs. We have, even for the skills, for all our important skills like project management, selling, financial and commercial acumen, total synchronization of the manufacturing space, we have licenses at three levels. We actually call them licenses. So license to sell, then an advanced license to sell, and then a master license to sell. And these keep evolving as time goes. So you're right, you cannot never say that, you know, we are up to date, because we will never be up to date. I think the moment you say that you're up to date, basically your decline has started.
Mm. Irene, if I was to give you a bit of paper and say, could you write down the top three leadership skills that will be necessary to take us into the future, to solve the problems of sustainability, to solve environmental issues, to make us more aware of what's happening on the planet, what would the top three be?
Leadership skills. So for me, it's about starts with you, me, self-reflection. You need to know yourself in order to really make the best and optimal placement out of your talents around you. So you need to be very self-reflective as a leader. And then you need to have really interpersonal skills. You need to have coaching skills to motivate people, to give them a purpose, articulate the purpose, and bring people behind you. And that in a modern way, but because we are not hierarchical anymore. Dipak alluded to the Cubic. It's an open atmosphere. You work in teams. It's not you give a command, people run. You need to give them trust that they do their best. So you need to act as a coach, and that's also another leadership skill.
Well, I said to Irene only three, so I give you the chance to add any more that you want to on top of that, Dipak.
I mean, I fully agree with them, firstly, and maybe one that's closer to my heart, and I think that's kind of the base level, is curiosity. You need to have, I think modern leaders now need to have literally childlike curiosity about the world, because it keeps changing. Every day it's new. And if you're not waking up curious, you know, you will not have the motivation to do new things and to lead new type of people. Because on the one side, you know, which Irene talked about is that is so close to our heart, this whole topic of diversity. And that also has a business side to it, because it's conclusively proven through enough research that well-managed diverse teams perform better than any homogeneous team. So it also has a business reason. Mm-hmm. And if you have to have that, we need these skills in the people, which is curiosity, which is what she talked about in terms of being collaborative and being the agility to learn. Mm-hmm. So I think that packages mm-hmm. it all.
Well, it's been a fascinating chat. Thank you both very much indeed. Did I get the job?
You still need to pass the skill side. We just covered the soft ones. So.
Yeah. A bit uncertain there. I was hoping for more than that. Deepak and Irene, thank you both very much.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
Thank you.